In this video, we'll be going over cards that are basically useless, or have effects which are so minor, they're almost never worth running. But this list will not go over cards with negative effects. Most of those are kind of designed to be bad, so they don't count. And at number 10, we have Red Eyes Black Metal Dragon. And I guess Metal Zoa counts here as well. In order to summon this card, you have to tribute a Red Eyes Black Dragon that was equipped with the trap card, Metal Morph. Then, you can special summon this card straight from your deck. What's unique about this card is it's one of the few which has an effect that allows it to special summon itself from the deck, without relying on another card to bring it out from the deck. It's basically just the Metal Morph rank-ups, i.e. Black Metal Dragon and Metal Zoa, and the familiar possessed cards that are able to do this unique special summon themselves from the deck thing. Now, what makes Red Eyes Black Metal Dragon almost useless is the fact that Red Eyes Black Dragon, equipped with Metal Morph, is better than this card. Red Eyes Black Dragon equipped with Metamorph will have 2700 attack, and the ability to gain half the attack of a monster it's trying to attack over, basically allowing it to attack over almost anything with less than 4000 attack. So, tributing Red Eyes Black Dragon with Metamorph equipped will give you basically a vanilla monster with 100 more attack, which is straight up a downgrade to the monster and card you're getting rid of to bring out Red Eyes Black Metal Dragon. The only good thing about Red Eyes Black Metal Dragon is the Darkness version that it's based on, Red Eyes Darkness Metal Dragon, who is one of the best Dragon-type monsters in the game. And Red Eyes Darkness Metal Dragon has nothing to do with Metal Morph, or the original Red Eyes Black Metal Dragon, which is probably why it's so good. Number 9, Wind Effigy. This card has the effect where it can be treated as two tributes for the tribute summon of a Wind Normal-type monster. Now, there are a lot of cards that have effects which allow them to be treated as two tributes for a specific attribute, but the thing with this card is that there are no wind normal monsters that require two tributes in the game. There is one card, though, called Simorgh, Bird of Ancestry, which has an effect that treats itself as a normal monster while it's in your hand. And Simorgh does have a tribute summon effect, so it is useful for this one card. But in that case, it probably could have just had an effect that said it was only used for this one card or something. Like, there are other Effigy cards, like Light Effigy and Dark Effigy, which are just like Wind Effigy, in that they can be used for two tributes for a tribute summon of a normal monster of their attribute. But there is actually tons of Light and Dark normal monsters that require two tributes. Those cards are actually more useful. But, to Wind Effigy's credit, it's at least an 1800 attack beat stick on a level 4 monster, which aren't the worst stats in the world. Funny enough, there is another monster called Whirlwind Prodigy, which can be treated as two tributes for any wind monster. So they didn't even really need to make Wind Effigy. There was already a card with a better effect in the game. But I guess Wind Effigy does have a better stat line. 1800 attack is better than 1500 attack on a level 4 monster. So at the very least, it's an okay level for a beat stick. Number 8, Card Shuffle. This card has the effect where you can pay 300 life points to shuffle either yours or your opponent's deck once per turn. Now, an on-demand shuffle of either player's deck is kind of a useless thing to do. There are some situations in which shuffling decks might be helpful, like if your opponent has stacked their deck and they're playing Sylvans or something, or if your opponent has stacked your deck and they're playing Spirals, or even in Duel Links, if your opponent is using Parasite Parasite, and you can preemptively shuffle your deck so you don't draw it. But in none of those cases do you want to go minus one in order to do that. Like, even as an incredibly specific counter card, this isn't a good counter card. There is almost no practical situation in which you want to shuffle your deck, outside of very niche cases. Funny enough, there is a skill in Duel Links, which is literally this card's effect. And as a skill in Duel Links, where you don't actually have to use a card in your deck or lose any kind of advantage to use it, it's still considered a bad skill, which means its card version is even less useful. Number 7, Enervating Mist. This card has the effect to make your opponent's hand size limit become 5, down from 6. So, if you're trying to counter a high hand count deck, like against a really gimmicky Slifer the Sky Dragon or Mooka Mooka deck, then you're better off playing this continuous spell card called Finite Cards, which lowers the hand size limit to 3. Because in case you don't know, the hand size limit is 6, and only applies during the end phase, where you can only have 6 cards in your hand before your opponent's turn starts. So you can have as many cards in your hand as you want during your turn, just as long as you only have 6 at the end of your turn. And lowering it to 5 doesn't really inconvenience any deck. Except maybe that gimmicky Slifer the Sky Dragon deck I was talking about earlier. In which case, there's already a power-crept version of Enervating Mist in the form of Finite Cards, making Enervating Mist basically useless, and already incredibly not useful even before its power-crept version came out. Number 6, Returning Zombie. This card has the effect where, during your standby phase, you can pay 500 life points to add this card from your graveyard to your hand. But you need to have no cards in your hand in order to activate and resolve this effect. Now, at first glance, this seems like a pretty useful effect, being able to straight up add a card to your hand from your graveyard by only paying 500 life points is good. So what makes this card useless? Well, this effect happens during your standby phase, the phase that happens directly after drawing a card. So like 99% of the time, you would have just drawn a card and not be able to use his effect because you'd have a card in your hand. Unless you're running a deck full of like quick play spell cards you use immediately, in which case you'd be able to add Returner Zombie to your hand. Or you're playing a whole bunch of cards that let you skip your draw phase, like Reckless Greed or Offerings to the Doomed. In those cases, you can use Returning Zombie's effect. And like 99% of other cases, you can't. So its effect is basically useless. Number 5. Larvae Moth. This card cannot be normal summoned or set, and doesn't have an effect, and only has 500 attack. And in order to special summon this card, you must tribute a Petite Moth on the second of your turns after Petite Moth has been equipped with Cocoon of Evolution. So, in order to bring out this card, which is not good, you have to send 2 cards on your side of the field who have been out for 2 turns, to the graveyard. And this card specifically needs to be in your hand after 2 turns. So basically, it has a convoluted summoning requirement to bring out a card that is absolutely not worth that summoning requirement. The only reason this card exists is because it's an earlier version of Cocoon of Evolution, which needs to be out for 6 turns in order to bring out Perfectly Ultimate Great Moth, which has the same summoning requirement as Larvae Moth, only it requires 6 turns instead of 2. And there's also Great Moth, which has the same summoning requirement but requires 4 turns. And Great Moth has 2600 attack, which is not half bad. Unlike Larvae Moth, who has 500 attack, which is really bad. Number 4, Elemental Hero Neo Bubbleman. This card cannot be normal summoned or set, and the conditions to special summon this card are currently impossible outside of using a Wild Monster Appears, a card which ignores the summoning conditions of a monster which cannot be normal summoned or set, in order to special summon it from your hand. And the reason this card can't be special summoned normally is because it requires you to send an Elemental Hero Bubbleman you control and the spell card Metamorphosis in your hand to the graveyard. And Metamorphosis is a banned spell card. So, what does this card do which requires you to discard a banned spell card? Well, it has an effect that treats its name as Elemental Hero Bubbleman while it's face up on the field, and if it battles an opponent's monster, you can destroy your opponent's monster at the end of the damage step. And with its incredibly low stats of 800 attack, that means if it attacks into another monster, it will probably die when trying to destroy the opponent's monster. Or if it's attacked by an opponent's monster, at least it will take down the opponent's monster in the process. So it's basically like a worst version of Yomiship, a card which surprisingly has better stats and doesn't have a convoluted summoning requirement. So not only is Neo Bubbleman almost impossible to summon, it's not anywhere near worth the effort to summon it anyway. And at number 3, we have Gryphon Wing. This card has the effect to counter Harpy's Feather Duster used by your opponent, and then destroy all of your opponent's spell and traps instead of your own. And since Harpy's Feather Duster is a banned card, and this is an incredibly specific counter card tied directly to Harpy's Feather Duster, this card is by definition unplayable. At the very least, though, Harpy's Feather Duster is legal in the OCG, which means it can see play in one of the formats, even if it's completely useless in the TCG. And at number 2, we have Guardian Elma. This card is a lot like Neo Bubbleman in that it requires a banned card in order to be summoned. This card cannot be summoned at all unless you control a Butterfly Dagger Elma face up on the field. And then, when this card is normal or special summoned, you can equip a spell card from your graveyard to this card, which isn't half bad of an effect. The only problem with this card, though, is Butterfly Dagger Elma is so good that it will never be unbanned without a change. Because for those of you who don't know, Butterfly Dagger Elma has an effect which allows it to return to your hand if it's destroyed on the field. An effect that's not once per turn, so it opens up all kinds of infinite loops. So just like Neo Bubbleman, this card can't be summoned because it requires a banned card. But unlike Neo Bubbleman, there is a higher chance Metamorphosis will be unbanned than Butterfly Dagger Elma will. But technically, you can summon this card with a wild monster appears as well. Although, just like Neo Bubbleman, it's not really worth it. And at number 1, we have Jar Robber, a card which can only be activated when the spell card Pot of Greed is activated. In which case, you negate the effect of Pot of Greed and then draw one card from your deck. So basically, a specific counter card to one card, and that one card is banned, and is like the poster boy for banned cards and will most likely never be unbanned unless they completely change its effect. Which is very doubtful because they keep releasing nerfed versions of Pot of Greed that see tons of play. So an unrestricted version of Pot of Greed is not gonna happen. So unlike Gryphon Wing, where Harpy's Feathers Duster is not banned in the OCG, Pot of Greed is banned in both formats. It's very doubtful that it will ever be unbanned in either of them too. And as honorable mentions for this spot, we also have Spirit of the Pot of Greed, which is a monster card that has an effect where, while it's face up on the field, if a player activates Pot of Greed, they can draw an additional card. And then Avatar of the Pot, another card which allows you to send Pot of Greed from your hand to the graveyard to draw 3 cards. Basically, both of them work with Pot of Greed in order to draw an additional card, which is pretty good, except for the fact that Pot of Greed is banned. And I wouldn't really include them on this list, because these cards can just be used normally without any kind of restrictions, unlike Guardian Elma or Elemental Hero Neo Bubbleman. They don't need Pot of Greed in order to be summoned, they just give Pot of Greed extra effects. Alright, and that's it for this video. If you know of any other really useless cards that should have made the list, I'd love to hear about them as well as ideas for future videos just like this one down in the comments.